Hi, I'm Kelly Hill, your guide to Whole Foods weight loss. Can you believe it? Here I am. You asked for it, you got it, video blogs. Who would have thought I ever would hit this spot in my life? So it's a perfect day though. So it's the day I wanted to go ahead and start it because we're in the middle of a powerful grassroots movement right here in my own hometown. So I want to make sure you can see this. There you go. See that? Whoops. Okay, there we go. See this? GMO ban passes. So my county here in Jackson County, Oregon, joins five other counties in Washington State and California that have now officially banned or limited the use of genetically modified organisms when they're farming. This is a really big deal. And several counties tried to get a ballot measure here in Oregon, and only Jackson County was successful. And the reason it was so important to do right now is that the Oregon legislature enacted a policy that says counties no longer have the option to do these kind of bans. So we were lucky. We got in before that that bill passed. And this is part of that information where the government is curtailing us and they're from taking back our food system. And this is important. We need to be paying attention to this. So you may be asking, Kelly, what's the big deal? So GMOs are super common in the United States, and yet they're banned in many other countries. And they're in every processed food that you're going to eat. If you're eating processed foods, you're eating genetically engineered organisms in your food. In fact, more than 80% of our corn in the U.S. is genetically modified. More than 90% of our soybeans are modified, and the government continues, the FDA continues to contemplate genetically engineered salmon. So this is everywhere, and we need to be paying attention to it. So the next steps, I mean, we get this excitement right here. We have GMOs banned. What's the next step? The next step is going to be GMO labeling. Now, earlier this month, Vermont passed the first state law to require labeling. Now, this will not go into effect, though, until 2016. Maine and Connecticut have enacted laws, but they don't go into effect at all unless the other regions surrounding them follow suit. So we're out there a little bit still. But here's the big exciting news. There are 85 bills right now being presented from over 30 states to talk about genetically modified organisms and the importance of labeling. So this becomes really important to everybody, whether you're in one of these states or not, to be paying attention to, because they have been defeated so far. These bills have gone down, unfortunately. And they've gone down, one of the biggest reasons is because, let's start with 2012 wasn't the first one, there was one before that, but let's start with the recent. 2012, California had the very first bill. Now the biotech corporations and food manufacturers spent $45 million to defeat that. And the supporters only spent $9 million. So guess what? Follow the money trail. Fear made that go down. Then in November, just this very last November, Washington State barely failed. Theirs was really close. But again, those same companies, $22 million raised and spent to defeat that. Only $8.1 million spent by the supporters of that bill. So follow that money trail. I've said it a million times. Follow the money trail and you'll find out what's really happening out there. And unfortunately, what we're finding out is it's time to take back our food supply. And we're going to have to do it at this grassroots level in order to make it happen. It's not going to happen otherwise. So I heard a quote from somebody, I wish I could remember who told me this, but if you know, let me know. But it was so wonderful. I want to make sure I don't mess it up. It says, we're becoming food citizens rather than food consumers addicted to fast, cheap, and conventional food. That's a very exciting, powerful movement to be part of. It's so exciting, and I want you to be part of it too. So find out how you can join in your area, and hopefully you'll be just like my county and you'll be banning GMOs and we'll all be getting them labeled, and we're going to end up healthier and happier. Thanks for listening in on this first video blog. I'll do more, I promise. Talk to you soon. Bye.